you can't hear. Can you hear on any of these?
There's something I want to ask you. What does assassination mean?
What happened, you know? Nobody said he's been shot.
So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
He said we can work together in the last analysis, and that what has been going on within the United States over the period of the last 3 years, the divisions, the violence, the disenchantment with our society, the divisions, whether it's between blacks and whites, between the poor and the more affluent, or between age groups or on the...
But it's a conversation with a former member of the hip-hop group Public Enemy, rapper Professor Griff, that has been called into question.
You can't be anti-Semitic when the Semitic, when we are the Semitic people, when we are the same, we give so much power to the theys. When we talk, and then the theys then turn into the Illuminati, the Zionists, the Rothschilds, the Bilderberg,
right.
The Freemasons,
right.
And
new emails found on Anthony Weiner's computer confirmed that Hillary Clinton was involved in a pedophilia ring.
I've heard that the New York police officers who saw some of it, even though they're hardened investigators, literally had to go throw up.
These people are not freaking humans, okay? Hillary Clinton is a goddamn demon.
I don't know, but that island was really a cesspool. There's no question about it. Just ask Prince Andrew. He'll tell you about it. The island was an absolute cesspool. So
the Clintons are friends.
Dr. Fauci? Bill Gates and Melinda? You want to depopulate the earth? What the hell gives you that right?
This is a fait accompli, you believe?
Oh, they think so. Oh, yeah, they think they won. That's the reason why they don't bother about me talking about it. They don't care whether you know or not. What are you going to do about it?
We are on the verge of war, but it is not yet too late to stay out. It is not yet too late to show that no amount of money or propaganda or patronage can force a free and independent people into war against its will.
Strong again. We will make America proud again. We will make America safe again. And we will make America great again. God bless you and good night. I love you.
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a...
I'm gonna talk...
It's only just begun.
They get me every time.
You like.
It's a bit of a cinematic adventure now, too.
I mean, if you gave me the real skills, man, I can make video. I can do it all.
Yeah, someone has to tell you what the top one is for clips.
I can't do it with my phone. I don't have enough money for like a computer or anything. So.
Yeah.
I mean, one day, dude.
Dude, I was looking at the stuff we were talking about earlier in the week, the Twitter shit.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah.
And some dude, like you were saying that the guy on Reddit thought it was China. Some dude thinks that it's hackers who are hacking these people's DMs. To
okay.
like take all their DMs and see who they're fucking talking to.
They're holding
to
them hostage.
Expose pedophilia.
Okay.
Yeah.
I can get with that, yeah.
I don't know. I was so unaware of the fact that Twitter is like a fucking vault, though. That blew my mind.
They got hacked in like, I want to say 2012. They made a fake like War of the Worlds thing where it was like
the
Obama's been attacked
yeah.
or something like that. That was the last time. And then Twitter was like, you can hack all these other ones, but you can't touch us. And
yeah.
then that was a show of how they can hack your Twitter.
Yeah.
But really, it's like mainstream media is like, oh, look, they hacked the Twitters. It's a Bitcoin scam. It's like, dude, they hacked Bill Gates' phone.
Yeah.
That dude's like above the government.
And Obama and Biden.
Like, think about that dude's phone. The encryption, like the fucking.
Just having that much money, you have to have a fucking bulletproof
some kind
life.
Of bullshit. You know what I mean? Like the Secret Service gives Biden and Obama phones.
Yeah.
So the whole idea that it's like a 400-pound hacker in the basement type thing with the neckbeard bullshit. Yeah. It's like maybe, dude, but this makes way more sense if an intelligence agency is doing this.
Yeah.
Now, is it our military intelligence? Is it some of the Five Eyes? Is it Mossad?
Yeah.
Or. Makes more sense if it's China. Yeah. Huawei.
Yeah, I mean, that shit is wild. And then I was also, did you, like, the conspiracy subreddit is just fucked.
Yeah, like it's like this Himalayan salt lamp.
Yeah, you can't see fucking anything. But I was like, well, I think it was on BitChute. I was watching a video of a dude.
Good. Yeah. Nah, go on.
Fucking John Legend and Chrissy Teigen's plane got turned around on the way to Tokyo.
When? Recently?
Just happened, yeah. They were going to Tokyo. The plane got turned around. And that's after she blocked 1 million people and deleted 60,000 tweets. Which
and she said, like, she was attacking Q.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they were on their way to Tokyo, which people think that it was for them to flee. And they're saying that there was a head count where two brothers got on the plane with one ticket.
So brothers, dude, like bros? Like
bros.
Related or yeah, brothers?
Just right, brothers.
Go on.
And like.
I didn't know you're talking about my melanated.
Nah, not the melanation. You're not getting on a fucking plane by accident, dude.
Nah, you don't actually.
It's just not happening.
It's not happening.
No one's sliding through that, dude.
I mean, did you see Fort Lauderdale?
You're not getting into the airport.
Did you see our Philly sisters down in Fort Lauderdale?
Yeah. They wigged. Dude, I mean, just imagine, like, in order to get there with one ticket, you'd have to pull the wool over.
I mean, people.
Three, four stages try of security.
If I have a plane ticket, it's hard for me to get on a plane.
Yeah, it's just hard.
My
in
white
general.
Privilege, like, doesn't get me into the plane. They're like, where's this? Where's this ID? Where's this? And I'm like, fuck, dude, I don't have all this shit on me because I'm a fuck up.
Yeah, but I saw that. I was like, holy shit. And, like, they're bodying Ellen, dude.
So Q's real. Dude, tell me what the fuck that is if that's not an ankle bracelet.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Is she walking around with a Walkman on her ankle? Like, come on,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, and there's pictures of her, like, on a boat hugging a little girl and shit, and it's like...
I don't pay any attention to them, because I could do that so easily with you.
Yeah.
Like, any picture of you out of the farm with those kids,
you're
a pedophile.
Yeah.
So I don't pay any attention to, like, random things like that. Even the weird art shit. Even the weird art shit, to me, my thing is, like, all right... You know normal people can't get with your weird Basquiat drawing.
Yeah.
But you know that there's a satanic pedophile conspiracy going on about you.
Yeah.
Take it off your fucking wall.
Just take it easy.
Just take it off your wall because you know Instagram this is going to happen.
Yeah.
Like, you're Tom Hanks, dude. Stop taking pictures of gloves, dude. That's all it is.
Yeah, they say that's
just
an
knock it the
expression.
Fuck off, man. Yeah. Because you look like you are a serial killer going through some kind of psychological healing of what you've done.
Yeah, I mean, if I was a dude, just a rogue guy who, like, every Saturday I went to a youth football game and people were like, yo, man, what the fuck are you doing? Like, nothing. I just like youth football.
Yeah, like, Dom's an umpire.
Yeah, it's just my release.
That's what he does, dude.
If someone's like, hey, everyone's calling you a pedophile, I would A, clear my name, and then B, be like, all right, guys, I'll chill. Like, sorry, I just enjoyed football.
Exactly.
But they're like the weirdness.
That shit with Chrissy Teigen's kind of blowing my mind. I didn't know about this.
Yeah.
So she was on a plane.
4 hours into it.
4 hours into the plane.
Over the ocean.
You're shitting yourself.
The plane turned around.
If you're on the run, you're John Legend. You're John Legend. Have you ever seen that Obama clip?
No.
Ha.
What?
Dude. Fuck. There's a clip. It's like some interview at an art show or something, art gallery or whatever. Yeah. And they're interviewing Chrissy and John Legend, and they're like, what's the craziest night you've ever had? Or some weird shit, right? And Chrissy
Was Bruno interviewing him?
I don't, yeah, pretty much. And then Chrissy Teigen's like, the Obama stuff. And they like zoom in. She says it, laughs, and runs off the screen. And they're just zooming in on John Legend. He's like, I'm not going to talk about that. And it's like, dude, what did you do with Obama?
Yeah, Jesus
like,
Christ.
What the fuck, bro?
Yeah, I mean that's the other thing that
that's what I was gonna say was like, dude, you're 4 hours into a flight, you're over the ocean, you're sitting there going like, we did it,
motherfucker,
we did it, we're
going to Tokyo,
we'll be safe in no time. And then the thing just like, you feel the plane start to go, it's like Indiana Jones. You're
I mean that's like a 3 minute turn.
Yeah. I know.
Just to turn completely around the other way, just to like, oh.
You're shitting yourself, dude.
Yeah, that is pumping me up that allegedly happened.
And then you feel the plane turn around, then you're going, there's U.S. Marshals on this plane.
Yeah.
And you're like, I'm fucked. I'm fucked.
Yeah, they said they did a head count. There was one too many people on the plane.
I don't understand why you'd even turn it around.
I feel like...
Like, if I was the extra person.
Yeah.
Like, I got on a plane. I got on trains before when I was younger like this.
Yeah.
To go to New York.
But, I mean...
And they'd be like, where's your ticket? I'd be like, oh, I thought I bought it on the train. And they're like, no, dude. They didn't stop the train.
Yeah. That's what... It was kind of confusing because, like, a head count 4 hours in... The fuck's the point of that?
I like this story. I like this.
Like, how's that going to do anything? You head count right when you're everyone's sitting. And you're like, all right, we're about to...
And they got some weird Instagrams. She's got some weird pedophile... Her tweets
are brutal.
I don't understand the pedophile jokes, man. I don't... You can't explain this shit to me.
Yeah.
Especially with, like, what's going... I got into a Bieber hole. Not a Bieber hole 69, but Bieber hole...
Oh, I thought you said beaver holes.
Like, I got in a beaver hole about how he was like going to like one of those Hawkeye churches.
Yeah.
And then ended up like, you know, kind of like in a meeting, sort of like an AA meeting or like whatever, like a group therapy session, saying how he witnessed a desanguination, like a ritual, satanic ritual feast on blood where they wear masks and they drain the blood of a fetus.
Yeah.
So he walked into a room. He was like at a party, and they took him in the back. They opened up the door, and he was secretly, Selena was secretly pregnant with his child.
What?
And they were trying to like lock him in. They were trying to get him into like the dark cult, you know? And like he walked in a room, and they were all wearing animal masks and drinking like red liquid.
Yeah.
And they had a baby that they'd been draining for like 3 hours, and they were laughing about how the baby stayed alive so long.
Where was this on?
Just some shit I saw on the internet, dude.
Holy
I mean,
fuck.
I can't cite my sources, bro.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
but like Bieber is sitting there now. That came out, and he was like, that's why he's gone on this whole thing of like, I want to be a family man. Like, this is fucked.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to be part of the music industry or anything. That's why he's like crying and shit. Yeah. And it's all fucked up because he says that after they showed him that. And he almost threw up and was like, I'm getting the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
They killed Selena Gomez's baby. And then that's why they broke up.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. And now he's on them fucking TikToks touching his... They're like... He just did another one. They're like, if Pizzagate's real... And it's like the comments when you're watching it is just pizza, 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 pizza. Yeah, like pizza signs. Yeah. And then like, if Pizzagate's real, touch your nose. And he just goes... Did it again.
Obvious
wow, as fuck. Yeah. Dude.
Yeah, I mean, dude, that's why, like, everyone's like, you're retarded. Movies aren't real. Talking about, like, all Shane's, like, fucking joking around about payment. It's like, dude.
I don't know why. You don't have to bring that back up. This is our one.
I know,
this
but I'm saying, like, them. You joke about that, but this is what these faggot-ass Satanists are doing.
This is spiritual warfare.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, like, whether or not the devil's fucking real, what they're doing is, and that's human sacrifice.
So, allegedly.
I mean, it seems like that's the way. It seems.
I look at it like climate change, man. I can't prove it, but let's act like
climate change been happening since like 1 BC.
But let's just act like it's happening.
Yeah.
Like,
be careful.
I'm just saying, like, all right, man, you're gonna sit there and go man-made climate change, and you want wind and solar and all that shit. It's like, all right, I'm on board because what if it's real?
Yeah.
All right. Well, there's satanic cults going around killing babies. It's like, oh, really? I can't prove it, but like, let's all start acting like it's real.
Yeah.
And let's start fucking wrapping everybody up that's acting like this.
Yeah. I mean, especially like Hollywood, there's way too many like oddities that go on between like not even correlated, but like all these people are all doing the weird shit. And then if you point any of it out, it's like, dude, you're fucking crazy. Why would you even think that? It's like, dude, look at all the shit they're doing. Look at the symbology. Look at all that.
I mean, how many times have we said it? Like, if you're fucking Steven Spielberg... And they're saying you got up in that poltergeist girl's guts.
Yeah.
Come on out and be like, dude, what the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, I don't know, man. I don't know what to say to that shit because it's fucking nuts. This is that Bieber post.
The Bieber post?
The Bieber.
Oh,
Jesus Christ. You know, Bieber, dude.
Bieber. Yeah.
Justin Bieber, dude. Do you got a fap or something? What's on your mind, dude?
Not even. Just love chicks, idiot.
Yeah, also, too, apparently Spain is waking up to the COVID fraud.
A lot of people are.
Spain's, like, revolting.
Yeah, dude, a ton of fucking countries are. And old, good old America, dude. Just be courteous and wear it. Just shut the fuck up, dude, okay? It's real.
It is weird, man.
I was at 3J's waiting for my sandwiches outside, and this dude is sitting on the fucking corner by himself. Literally zero people around. Me and him might be 15 feet away. Pulls the mask off one ear, sips his coffee, then puts it back on. It's like, dude, what is this? Is this just like a different level of simping where you're trying to be like, hey, girls, like...
Yeah, it's simping to a, it's like a virtue signal simp thing. Yeah, well, definitely.
That's the weird shit about a lot of this is because like most, I would feel like most fucking normal ass dudes.
Did you ever find out if that was a tranny or not?
Where?
The OK Boomer?
Oh, Nico? I don't know.
All right. Let's, anyway.
Big hands, but it doesn't matter. Go on. Yeah, whatever. Curious. She's that, I mean, I wouldn't even be able to look at her if it was a girl, boy.
Kind of curious. But,
yeah. Hey, man. What the fuck? Do you need a jerk off? Do you?
I didn't this morning, which is weird, but
yeah, whatever. Yeah, but like the weird shit that dudes are doing just for sniz.
It's beyond that. It's like their whole family. It's like team. It's real divisive team building shit that they've done.
Yeah,
where like they've got
their fucking families up.
They're fucking everybody up. I mean, they're if you don't think that we're being ripped apart by the at the seams, dude, you're not paying attention.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the thing. Like, you know how you said everything was like crazy since Kobe died.
It is weird. Do you remember?
But at the same time,
that fucking dude was like, this is going to kick off some weird Masonics.
You could back that up to Epstein and all his shit unraveling.
I mean, I guess there's a really cool, there's really cool shit that you can get into. There's like books where people have studied history and like how history goes in cycles.
Yeah.
And like, you know, we're headed towards. Like,
I mean, in your intro, the dude was, Kennedy was saying the same exact shit.
Yeah, I mean. My answers are pretty meta, but there's this book called The Fourth Turning. These guys wrote this book called Generations. It's all about how like history doesn't repeat itself. Like Mark Twain said, like it doesn't repeat itself, but it rhymes.
Yeah.
And it's like you can kind of see these things coming. So yeah. There's these dudes that studied this shit, and they like nailed it. Like there's going to be a pandemic. Like they nailed all this shit. They predicted it all.
Yeah.
And it's not looking good. It's looking like we're going to have like 5 years of absolute destruction. The country's going to fall apart. Currency's gonna die, and then we're gonna have to rebuild the whole world on a new economic. Basically, I'm looking at this shit going, maybe Nasara.
Yeah.
Maybe we are gonna fucking.
Depending on who gets their hands on it, yeah.
Maybe we are gonna have to revolt and overthrow because the current. The
so dick, dude, because I was just trying to fucking program and finish my house, and now I know, I know. This.
The level of security that you need to protect our economy is not sustainable.
Feasible, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. The all this stuff, it doesn't seem good. Like a lot of people are posting on Reddit and shit, like they're just fucked. Like their heads are fucked. They don't know what's normal anymore. Everything just seems like it's going over the fucking waterfall and crashing down.
Like what do you mean when you say that?
Like life, like normalcy as we used to know.
Oh yeah, it's not gonna happen again.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. We're like 5 years, like this is the beginning. We were at war.
Yeah.
This is like the beginning of it. I mean, it's gonna get weird. We might not be able to do this.
Yeah, I don't
it's
know.
It's going to keep getting weirder and weirder.
Unless something crazy.
It's pretty clear now this lockdown isn't about a fucking cough.
You're out of your mind.
You know what I mean? So
You're literally a goofy fucking retard if you think that. And it's like, dude, I forget what it was on a podcast or something. It's like there's flu seasons, and then there's another season.
Yeah.
And this has been going on since March, and then there's no new season. It's just a compiling of numbers.
Well, what they're going to be able to do is say what they want to do is try to create coronavirus as a new flu, a new season that involves a shutdown.
That's absurd. That's not sustainable unless you are someone who wants a welfare state and people completely.
Dr. Fauci?
Yeah, completely begging for the government to help them. That's like I saw on the Philadelphia subreddit a dude from the trash cut, like the Philly trash. They put out a thing like, we're the real fucking heroes because half of their staff has coronavirus. You know what's crazy, dude? They're the only trash company I know who are currently dealing with coronavirus like this because all the private companies have none of that.
They're also going to privatize trash. They're pushing to privatize trash right now.
They should.
That would be cool.
Dude, Philly trash blows.
They just didn't pick it up last week.
And they're like, we're 50% staff. It's like, is it because coronavirus or is it because they're getting paid fucking more to stay home and say they have coronavirus?
Yeah, I don't understand what's going on because, I mean, not like I ever did, but like they are dragging this on for so long.
Yeah.
They're pretty much now, it was funny, I was painting this dude's house who's a teacher. And he's like, oh, yeah, the kids are just going to Zoom in September. This was back in March, maybe?
Yeah, it was a 15-day shutdown.
Like, right when
shutdown.
It started, remember that? And yeah. He was like, oh, dude, they're not going to go back to school in September. I was like, this guy's nuts.
Yeah.
And he was totally right. He was a teacher. He totally knew what was up.
Yep.
Because he knows parents aren't going to ever feel comfortable now. Now homeschooling is going to go up. But the problem with that is everyone's retarded, and you're going to have a bunch of Q moms.
Yeah.
And the next generation of kids are going to be wackos, beasts. Dude.
But, dude, it's like a double-edged sword.
Just sitting like, there like, 888 is 311. Yeah. 311 is the ninth.
Pizza equals 33, so does
the storm is coming.
The good thing about that, though, is like I was reading something where they are going back to that, but like some people are doing it in a Roman-esque style, like how the old Romans used to learn.
Hell yeah,
where
dude.
There's no structured schooling. Yeah. You just follow your passion. That's how you become
the
beast.
That's how the elites educate their. It's monastery school.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like you were saying on the other cast, like
that's how they get taught.
Who became a surveyor? Washington.
Yeah.
Washington became a surveyor, dude. And what grade did he go to?
I'm telling you, that's how all of the British elites, like the dukes and the lords and stuff, that because they're living in a castle, they have servants. It's like, oh, what are you into? And they just follow their own little trips all day.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The fact
we are all slaves. Like when you see them up close and you realize how hard and how long of a fight you have to survive.
Yeah.
You start looking around and they're like, oh shit, I'm in prison, but they just let me drive around.
Exactly.
And then like, dude, if you fuck up, you get in trouble.
Yes.
It's like you're already a slave.
You're fucked.
And like you're working and you're like trying to survive and then like shit goes wrong. Like my van kind of knocked the other day, and I was on the side of 95 on one of the hottest days, just sitting there just going, yeah, so, okay, yeah, nah, we're cool. It's like,
I mean, you're pretty
I can't
much
fucking win, man.
Yeah, you're in prison with unlimited rec time. That's about it.
Pretty much, yeah.
You got in a wicked commissary from doing your painting, and that's about it.
What was the, I was watching something where, I was watching that Rogan on the UFOs.
What?
Rogan just did another one of them. You remember that dude, Bob Lazar,
and he
had that other guy on?
His, like,
the fucking filmmaker's a jerk off. Yeah, yeah, they brought, that fucking dude came back on, but the guy he brought on was, like, a cool radio dude. And he was saying, like, he's like, I was thinking Hollow Earth the whole time because he's talking about other civilizations, like the Vimanas and all this shit. Yeah. And he goes, people might not be ready to find out the truth about us. Because we might just be like some project gone wrong.
Yeah.
We could be in a zoo.
Yeah.
We could just be like, they could be harvesting us.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Like, it's like, this guy's saying like, dude, do we even want to find out? Or just live your life?
Yeah. I mean, I'm cool where I am right now.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm just, not to sidetrack it, but I was just sitting there thinking like, I'm sitting there like I'm a slave. It's like, dude, what if we're just getting harvested?
Oh, yeah. And, dude,
they're just harvesting souls on an interdimensional level, dude. Rogan's Jones
been,
said it.
Yeah. Rogan has been doing the Lord's work, dude. He had that bay on.
I mean, that's just common sense coming back to the people.
I mean, I hope.
I got in fights with my uncle and my mom. I got in fights when that shit started.
So did I. I was like,
this shit. I was like, what are you talking about? I was like, this shit is fucked. And they're like, no, not necessarily, blah, blah, blah. And it's like they're having groups of trans talk to each other.
Yeah.
And it's
confirmation
like,
bias.
Well, they're just friends, dude.
The funniest
remember
shit.
Remember how like everybody would, I don't know about your age group, but in my grade, I never got into anything. Like a thing, like a clique or anything.
Yeah.
But there was like skaters, wiggers, goth kids.
Yeah.
Like they just formed. It's like.
The best
imagine if trannies was one of them.
Yeah. The best example I've ever heard is from you when this shit first started, and when you were like, dude, if you let me do whatever I want when I was 12, I'd have a Guns N' Roses tattoo on my back.
Oh, yeah.
Like, these people can't decide things for themselves for life, dude.
Use your illusion.
Like, it is so insane that, like, this is even an argument. This just goes to show you that the media is pushing this.
I used to, like, vacuum the basement and, like, be like, this is the end, man. The doors were so deep.
Jim Morrison wouldn't even face the crowd. Yeah, I mean, it's infuriating to even try to, like, hear someone's... Because even, like, Rogan had to do it. Like, he was just, like, giving the, like, devil's advocate. But, like, it's like, dude, but what... Their only thing is, like, what if they just know? It's like, you don't. Oh, you don't just know.
I tried to circ myself when I was, like, 9.
Yeah, dude.
What if with my dad's Bic razor, because I thought that would be sharper than scissors.
Dude,
that's exactly. That's a 9-year-old.
But they're going to chop your
I was
dick
ready
and
to do a body mod. Yeah, I got made fun of.
You were BME Junior.
I got made fun of, and I was ready to mod it up. And I was in the bathroom for
that
too long.
That would have been heinous.
I don't know what my dad was like psychic with that. I must have been in the bathroom for a real long time. And he must have been able to see. Maybe the door didn't shut all. Our house wasn't like the best construction.
Yeah.
Maybe the door didn't shut all the way or something. Because I was sitting there like pulling my fucking foreskin.
How are
like,
you trying to
I
do
I was
it?
Trying to guillotine it. So I would like pull
was
it.
Was it like a fucking old school razor?
Yeah, like a yellow blade? Like Ooh. A yellow plastic white handle.
Yeah.
You know, like my dad just had those.
Yeah.
And like I pulled it out. I was like, all right, I'm just going to fucking take care of this right now. Because if I do, I imagined in my head what I would have to do to get my dick to look like everyone else's.
Yeah.
And I was like, all right, cool. I'll just
a true artist.
I'll just pull this out real tight. Blah, blah, blah. And then it's like, my dad was like, hey, bud, you all right in there? Oh. Yo, if you want to do that, we'll go to the doctor. Like, he knew what I was doing.
Oh, my
I was
God.
All embarrassed. Dude. I, like, dropped everything. I was like, what? I just had to pee. Fucking rolled. Yeah.
I mean, that is fucked up. And the more you look into it, it's like.
Imagine if like, I was going to school and they're like, you like to draw? You're kind of sensitive. Are you a girl?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I'd start tucking it back, fucking looking like it puts a lotion on the skin, like Buffalo Bill, dude.
They're just like really nice bullies now. Like, wow, you like flowers?
Yeah.
You're a girl. You know that, right? You are a girl.
And then you like go back to class and there's like two other ones and you're like, I guess they're my friends now.
Yeah, shit. Yeah, I mean, it's just like the argument for that is just so insane. That's why I read on Matt and Shane's last time. It's like, dude, just stop doing this shit because the stats this chick's hitting us with, the amount of you fuckers who are actually affected with gender dysphoria is so small. And
well,
to say
it
they're
went
all
up 4,000% or something.
Yeah. And to say they all, that would mean pretty much all of them exist in West Philly.
Well, they move here.
Oh, yeah. You did say that. That's a hate.
They move here from all over the country. Yeah.
Why, dude? Because guys like you live in West Philly.
Ha. From the top rope.
Yeah, I don't know. Like that shit just sends me in a swirl, dude.
Yeah.
The fact that schools won't like
we could just get back talking about like Chris Teigen or something cool like that. Man, what's up with the Great Awakening?
it is weird. Like the more this shit comes out, the more I think about homeschooling a kid. For them to sit there and be able to call your
you
kid.
You realize now that the education system's brainwashing.
It's fucked.
It was brainwashing before, but they were brainwashing you for factories, for like certain jobs.
Obedience.
Now they're brainwashing you to destroy the country.
Yeah.
They're brainwashing you to go out there and be an activist.
Which is hilarious.
I mean, Nick Cannon has a degree from Howard.
Does he really?
Yeah. Just graduated.
Oh, he just graduated?
He just graduated from Howard.
Nice.
So it's like... I mean,
what do they teach you over there? Nick, get a few classes.
The crazy thing is,
I'm
like,
familiar
that's,
with the caucus.
I've listened to so many Professor Griff podcasts.
Are you serious?
Oh, yeah, dude. Like,
you're a fan.
That I love how the mainstream media doesn't play the real clip.
What's the real clip?
Like the real clip that they play is the thing about white people.
Yeah.
The real reason.
Oh yeah.
The real reason that he got fired was because what I put in my intro, but you won't find that. That's from the actual podcast.
Holy shit.
Yeah, because they won't the mainstream media wants to stoke the white versus black flames. And people are like, "Oh, he got fired for saying anti-Semitic shit." And
the fact that a black dude would get fired for saying wrong stuff about white people is laughable.
I know, and it's like All of the comments are all like, I didn't hear anything anti-Semitic. I didn't hear anything anti-Semitic.
Yeah.
All they're passing out is this 4-minute clip of him talking about basically white people don't have melanation, so they don't have any sympathy or soul.
Yeah.
They're savages.
Yeah.
That's the clip that's getting passed around.
I mean, that's like mainstream knowledge right now in college.
But I mean, if you enjoy Professor Griff like I do, you'll sit and listen to the whole podcast. and they'll talk about the Blue Bloods and the Rothschilds and parentheses they.
Dude, when they hit
with and the ADL watches that and they're like, goodbye, Nick Cannon.
Yeah, they sparked out.
Yeah, and then but then if there's a way to make money off of them, it'll just be like Deshaun Jackson. They'll be like,
I showed him the
Nick apologized. Yeah. Nick apologized. Everything's fine, guys. We'll get back to normal.
It is like, I mean, I lost my shit a few podcasts ago about this.
I just wish like white dudes had like a Malcolm X glasses thing.
Yeah,
I could just get a little outfit together where I start acting all fucking intelligent.
Yeah, you just put on glasses and go, so there was the Barbary slaves.
Up in the Caucasus Mountains, it was cold, so they don't have any sympathy for anyone.
Again, just speaking truth, dude.
Yeah, I love how like they go back to the 90s with like weird Farrakhan shit, and all of that's like pseudo social sciences, and like, dude, all that shit comes from like neo-Nazi stuff.
Yeah,
where they're sitting in the mountains and they're like, we're the only ones with intelligence. Like,
they're not white.
Yeah, like white people are the only ones with intelligence because they had to survive in the elements, and like it's literally
we soak up more vitamin D, Nick.
it's the same argument just on its other head.
Yeah,
but the crazy thing is that like people don't.
What if we could just unite?
I love how in the beginning of this, like 5 years ago, I remember sitting and everyone spurging out at a fucking, everyone like starting to fight at a dinner party type thing.
Yeah.
And I was just like, dude, this is identity politics stuff does not lead anywhere good. And everyone's like, no, we need it. Blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, what the fuck? Now you're watching this Nick Cannon shit. It's like, well, where the fuck did you think this ended up?
Yeah.
Like, this is where this ends, man. People start talking about how you can see the blue in their veins. Because their skin is white. Their skin is translucent because they don't have any soul from the sun.
Our brothers are very, very conspiratorial.
Oh, yeah, dude. I've worked, like, whenever I work with a black dude, within, like, fucking 5 minutes, man, we're in central banking, Rothschilds, lizard people, all of it, dude.
Yeah, you say 5G and their ears perk up. Like, you know about that?
Yeah, they love it.
Yeah.
But there is truth to it, like... There's no, I mean, the comments on the Nick Cannon thing are hilarious because they're like, oh man, you know that he's just got fired because of the truth. And it's like, nah,
we need more truth.
Yeah, man. I'm like, nah, man. But,
Nick, come on over to war mode, pal.
There's a weird thing where, you know, they see it. They see Israel attacking Iran right now.
Yeah.
And they're trying to drag the United States into like more covert ops, if not even covert, like ops.
Yeah.
Fighting Iran. And it's like, they're trying to squeeze this in case Trump loses. Because they know that if the shoe's on the other foot, they're playing hardball again. Like the Obama people, they did not fuck with them as much. They were way more kowtowing to the Muslims.
Yeah.
So it's like, the Israel's like, oh, shit, we might be running out of time. Attack Iran. You know what I mean?
It is insane. Like,
how's like... Little small fries like Nick Cannon, little Nick Cannon, gonna fucking understand what's going on in geopolitics, man. Exactly. When he's reading books from, I don't know,
I don't know
who gives these guys the doctor title. If these guys are doctors, man, who? I'm like,
is Nick Cannon a doctor?
All the books that stuff comes from is like doctor.
Oh yeah,
you know what I mean.
Go to Howard.
It's like, check out Doctor This. Doctor, yeah, I can't. I mean that's from Howard University.
Yeah. That's like, who the fuck was talking about that? It might have been the Weinstein thing with Rogan, where he was talking about how like, do you want? Oh no, it was Candace Owens interviewing the Black Lives Matter guy. Like, do you want like an all white school? You want to see how that goes? Because like in those universities, I can tell you right now how it's probably going.
Yeah, and there's people that buy in a race are like, they don't realize that you can turn a black. Take a black dude.
Yeah.
You can turn his great... He'll be alive and his great-grandkids will be white.
Yeah.
They'll look white.
Yeah.
That's how flimsy...
Race is.
Well, it's just... Skin's just an organ, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, all that shit is... All of those traits are just adaptations. So it's like... Basically just like height, hair, everything else.
Yeah.
The whole spectrum of it lives inside your genetic code.
Yeah.
So if... Since we're the same species, and we are.
Yeah.
Sorry, Nick. you could take... There's black intellectual dude, Thomas Charlie Williams. He's half black. His kids have blonde hair and blue eyes.
Yeah. That's wild.
Their kids will just be white.
Yeah.
they'll forget they were even part black.
Yes.
That's where you get that ancestry thing where it's like, holy shit, I'm black.
Yeah.
And white dudes are like, what? It doesn't take long. It doesn't take long, man, to lose your soul. I mean, the sun doesn't even talk to us.
Yeah. You debunk that pretty hard when you're just like, yeah, white people actually get more vitamin D.
Oh, our skin and like...
not bragging.
Well, it has to try.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, fuck, give me the sun. We need the sun.
We're not humans.
Yeah.
Yeah, that shit is fucking very hilarious how he gets canceled for that. It's like, so are Jews more victimized than blacks? Brett Weinstein tried to put that out there and got shut the fuck down by Glenn Larry.
They do that all the time. They do that all the time, and it really is fucking...
It's insane.
It's insane. It is insane. It is really insane, man.
To look a black dude down the eye and be like, hey...
us too.
Us guys, you know, we got a bad...
Like, it is wild, man.
It's bizarre.
It's bizarre.
It makes no sense.
None at all. I mean, in the... I guess there was a time with the pogroms and stuff. That's it, man.
When was that?
That was like 60 years ago.
The what?
Whenever World War II was.
Oh, wow, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not here, though, bro.
I don't know, man. It's just wild. It's like every time. It's like, dude, are you fucking for real?
Yeah, we're talking about slavery.
You're not right even going to let him have that?
Yeah. Talking about a whole thing about slavery, not the one time you guys got rounded up. Well, you know, can't say that or else we'll get canceled.
I mean, what are they going to cancel us from? Yeah.
They got a few things they can pick from.
No, I'm saying like from what, though? We're not like on TV.
I'd have to go back to always driving trash trucks.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. That's what, like, the media's been, they've been in, like, overdrive, because that shit you hit me with the Bitcoin, I legitimately just thought that was 100% just a scam, like a Bitcoin scam.
Yeah, I think what they're doing now with the news,
like, even on Reddit, they're doing it.
I think what they're doing now with the news is, like, they're making everything so, like, fluffy and, like, everything's just, like, nothing. Everything's, yeah, like, vanilla, just, like... You're so desensitized at this point.
Oh, my God.
They can twist. They can make these stories just like, oh, yeah, and then this happened. And you just go, okay, it's 100 days till the election.
Yeah.
People are just on their sides. And all this, anything that goes down now, they'll be able to spin however they want. No one's going to pay attention to it. They infiltrated Reddit, and Reddit's turned into just nothing but fucking political stuff on every sub.
Yeah.
So it's like... There's no way to really get away. There's no way to escape it now. It's just like, if that dude gets elected again, what are you going to do? Are we going to have another 4 years of this? Yeah, I mean, talk about sore losers, man.
Yeah, this is, I mean.
You're going to rip the country apart again?
Yeah. We couldn't even chill for a little bit.
I don't understand what the big deal is, man.
Yeah, I mean, it's the whole time it's literally just been one fucking thing after another saying none of this is fair. And it's like, dude, just... Get a good candidate and do it in 4 years. That's how easy it is. And you fucking retards get Biden. Joe Biden.
Sniffing kids' heads.
Yeah, it's just like, guys, look within. Don't look out. Don't look at everyone. Project on everyone what they're doing. Stop with projecting. Just look inside and see what we're doing wrong. You're propping up the wrong people.
What would be cool is if people stopped getting into this shit with the media and the politics and all this dumb shit. I had this cool idea for like, setting up retreats with like small groups of dudes. I know this sounds gay, dude. I know you're interested already.
All ears.
And
doesn't matter, like
I'm saying like
BMI or get, no?
Nah, BMI is cool, height,
okay.
Everything.
Okay.
So
random dudes got
dudes are there and you sort of like boot camp, but for like life. Right? So it's not like you're not gonna be sitting there with like a drill sergeant or anything.
Yeah.
But you lay there, you go there, you got your whole shit, you lay your whole shit out. Of who you are.
Yeah.
No holds barred.
Yeah.
I'm talking like you're ready to hand people your phones.
There's already a thing that exists.
Oh, really?
Yeah. London Real had the guy on. It's so expensive. He's some like weird like billionaire who's a total asshole, and he does this. Like they box and everything.
No. Okay. That's gay. What I'm talking about is like.
Just dudes chilling.
So like take you.
Yeah.
You're sitting here. I talk to you a lot. You're on a life path. Sometimes you get tripped up with this weird bullshit on the news.
Yeah.
Whatever. Mm-hmm. You get angry. You have your fucking weird shit sometimes.
Yeah.
There's you doing you. You can't really see your problems.
Yeah.
Because you're you.
Yeah.
You're in it.
Yeah.
Other people can. So if you can get with a group of dudes that'll sit there and go, all right, all together, though, no matter what level of life you're on, we're going to take all of your weird shit. We're going to break it down. We're going to figure out what you're doing wrong. Then we're all going to agree, like, all right, dude, Bill, this is going to be your game plan for the next year.
Yeah.
And then you're going to go out there in the world and do you. And then come back at the end of the year. It's sort of like the programming thing with Wes.
Yeah.
But way, way more real because you're putting out all of your failures.
Yeah.
Instead of like your goals.
It seems like that would help a lot of people. Like just walking around the city and like
realizing that if you could realize that you're projecting most of the time.
Yeah.
That you are taking in a reality that is being fed to you, and then you're filtering the reality you're seeing, you're filtering it through your own damaged fucking ego.
You have your own little archangel.
Yeah, your damaged ego, and then you're projecting your damages out into the fucking world onto other people.
Yeah.
If you could get everyone to stop doing that, the media wouldn't be able to fucking play on your heartstrings like this. They wouldn't be able to fuck you up during the day.
Yeah.
You would see that Nick Cannon type shit and just be like, oh, yeah, whatever, dude. The guy's fucking...
Yeah,
and it's not up there yet.
Like,
because it's a way you build compassion for people that are out there sitting there, like, with the masks on.
Yeah.
And the kids, the parents that are afraid to stop their kid from transing.
Yeah.
Like, you have to have compassion for how psyop they are.
Yeah, they're fucked.
But, like, we're in the minority of people that understand that.
Yeah.
And then if we could get in groups and, in order to be able to do that, you kind of have to break yourself down. Not a lot of people are going to do that. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
A lot of people live in their little ego castles.
Yeah. It is crazy, especially once you start paying attention to projection. And then you go out in Bryn Mawr and everything's like, hate has no home here. We hate no one. Hate everyone. It's like,
for me, when I drive by and I see hate has no home here, I know how you treat minorities.
Yes.
When they work on your house.
Yes.
You know what I mean? I know how you treat others.
It is insane.
I know how you treat lesser thans. And there's whole neighborhoods. Like, I have to work in them.
It's wild.
I know that you are going to call someone about me being on the phone. Yeah. I know that you're not going to let me use your bathroom. I know how you treat people.
Yes.
It's wild.
I mean, that's like... projection is a wild, like, unlocking
That's like
skill.
A level one thing, too.
Yeah.
So, like... if we could all get in like a pack, but the thing is that you have to expose yourself to other people, your entire plan, what you want to do, where you want to go, what your values are, and then say, this is me though.
Yeah.
And then other dudes that don't have your jam ups will be like, dude, you just got to do this.
Yeah.
And then it's going to hurt because you're going to be like, I'm not like that.
Yeah.
I'm not like that. But dude, you fucking are.
Yeah. That's like the shit you were saying a while ago. Like, you're the only reason you're at where you're at.
Yeah, it's no one wants to hear it. Nobody wants to hear it.
The minute I heard it, I was like, man, but
I mean, Nick Cannon was saying that on his podcast.
Yeah.
Stop blaming everyone else. You know what I mean?
Yeah. That is literally like no different than when you call someone a simp and they're just like, oh, no, dude, I'm not a simp. Because
exactly, yeah.
He's like, yeah, literally no one, unless someone is literally owning you, you're the reason you're where you're at.
I mean, there's people that just live in their own egos and then they sit there and they don't even know why they're reacting to stuff.
Yeah.
And their reactions, if they're good. What happened is back when we had a better society, or like a more close-knit, like families and stuff, if you started acting weird, that would get checked real quick.
Oh, my God. Dude.
But now, since there's no checks and balance, now you can find a group of other people that are acting like
especially
nasty women.
Especially with the internet.
Yeah, and it's like you go out there and it would be better if we could just tighten it up and be like, dude, I get what you're saying. That's not going to help you.
Yeah.
That behavior you're doing, it's not going to help you.
Yeah. I mean, that's like if you can just unlock the projection part of it, just one-on-one dealing with people, what knowing about projection, like when you're like, dude, why the fuck would someone just say that to me? You like you can start like, to handle people
you
better.
Might like read comments about how you have breasts. Oh. It's weird.
Not breasts, dude. Not breast.
Yeah, well,
so it's almost a week now, dude. It's crazy guy now.
Sorry, I forgot.
Get a binder.
Yeah, I'm gonna get a binder. I'm gonna trans. Who would have thought? I mean, I might be transing. You don't know me. I might be on TRT, dude.
Well, you wouldn't be on
or whatever.
TRT.
You'd be on HRT.
You'd be on estrogen.
Yeah, whatever the estrogen one is.
Yeah, I mean, That is a weird thing. That was happening with the doll girl chick, and obviously, like, I don't stand for anything the fucking girl does. Like, everything she does, I don't fucking, I'm not cool with any of that shit. Yeah. I think it's, like, her with the whole, like, who's straight nowadays, but, like, she, besides the weird dog shit, that's where kids are at today.
Yeah,
so that, instead of that's hearing that and giving her money, you're just as bad if you're sitting in the comments like, dude, she has ass pimples. It's like, get rid of all that weird judgy shit.
Yeah. Well, don't worry about what people look like, because that's not going to get anywhere.
If you want to. If you want to go on Spud Mode and start talking about people's looks, selfie first. If you put up a selfie, nah, say whatever you want.
Don't even promote this. See, this is why we got to have the group where you're a demon.
Yeah.
We got to say no, Bill.
It is just insane.
Not everything. There's a thing that guys get into where it's like everything becomes PAs. Everything becomes a locker room. You can't live your whole life like that.
Yeah.
Because if you think it's just fucking around, at some level, dude, it stops being fucking around.
Yeah.
It starts to turn into like
fights break out.
Real nasty, well, not even fights. I'm saying like nasty projections that go on for decades.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you think it's fun and games. If that's your surface level ball busting,
yeah,
it's fun and all. But like, there's a level of dudes that stays in that.
Yeah.
And they carry it on for so long that like
you end up working
with those old dudes that can't, dude, not only do they do that, they can't hear a fucking thing about themselves.
Oh, I know.
You know what I mean? So it's like the growth level there is low.
Yeah.
And dude, they didn't have to. They had boomers had it made.
Yeah.
We have to level up to survive what we're about to get into. We have to level up interdimensionally, man.
Yeah, literally.
Like we're fighting a spiritual war. So
it is definitely going to be fucking tough.
Step one. Doesn't matter what you look like, dude.
Yeah.
What if you got hit by a car? We gotta start making fun of how you're fucking crippled now?
Probably.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, the look shit is, it's just weird. On like every cast, especially now it's video, it's like,
nah, don't even sweat that. I'm saying like it goes into I'm trying to think of a way to, you're not getting anywhere. I don't know how to say it, man.
Yeah.
It's like one of the first hurdles of how you can like say, okay, so that doesn't matter anymore. Yeah. What's next?
Yeah.
Oh, how much money people have? Okay, that doesn't matter anymore.
Yeah.
And like you start getting down to what matters and where we're headed.
Yeah, I mean that shit like a lot of that goes on like with people I know, like the worrying about what other people have, how they have that, immediately freak out and say it's their mom, and it's like, well, I know that your mom gives you this too. It's like, dude, just fucking focus on yourself.
And what's this Mexican standoff doing for anyone?
Yeah.
Where are we getting?
Literally.
Like, we are actually at war right now.
Yes.
So.
Expect, like, I was in the car. I had to drive up to Sellersville to pick up one of our trucks with my dad, and he had, like, the fucking news radio is so bad, dude.
Regular radio is pretty bad right now.
All.
What's he got on? Like, 610 or
KYW.
Something? Yeah, yeah.
They listen to it like it's white noise. My other uncle, I had to go inspect the truck, same thing. And it's just like a stream of consciousness that is just bullshit. Like all the corona shit, shutdowns. And like they'll just sit there and be like, that's bullshit. And just keep on driving. It's like, dude, just turn all this stuff off.
Yeah.
It like,
if you think that it's not having an effect on you, it is. Yeah. That's what I'm trying to say. Like you create, not only do you create your own reality, you create your own reality based on what's coming at you.
Yeah.
If what's coming at you is constant fucking horseshit, man, how are you going to create where you want to go?
Yeah, I mean, I can just tell with, like, the level of conversations. Like, I can literally steer a conversation with any boomer right now, no problem.
No problem, yeah.
You start talking to them and then just be like, they're like, oh, well, you know, the coronavirus is pretty bullshit. And then you just go, those looters are, you know what I mean? And then immediately you're off, dude. Like, you can get a boomer and go any way you want with them. With, like, three little jabs, you can see which way they want to go and just take that conversation.
And I don't fault them for that, but I feel like the world, just like in the Caucasus Mountains, how white people had to lose their souls, I don't think that the boomers had the challenges.
None.
To turn themselves into savages.
Yeah.
But psychologically, we have to kind of become savages to survive the yo-yo of what the media is trying to do to you right now.
Yeah. I mean, if you just pay attention, like, if you're an alien looking at Earth and you're just seeing this timeline just happen, you'd be sitting there like, what the fuck?
Yeah. We have had worse sickness. Like, this sickness shit is not making any sense.
None.
So, I don't know what to tell you about that.
Yeah, it's, I mean, and then, like, dude, I hear you. People, you know,
this is the only pandemic I've never seen a sick person.
Yeah.
Or if you got a cold or a pneumonia, like, dude, I had pneumonia before. I'm pretty sure I had swine flu.
Yeah.
I didn't also, at the same time, have to become the poorest individual on the planet. I don't understand what's going on.
It's
people get sick, dude. It sucks. No one gave a fuck about sick people last year.
No.
In 2019, if you got sick, dude, no one gave a fuck.
Yeah.
And it's like
they. It's nuts. But the thing is, they have these programs and stuff to see what people are searching, see what people care about, and then like this is just probably something that got spit out of a fucking algorithm. Like, oh, a lot of people. Oh, they care planned about this.
They yeah. definitely planned that. That Fauci clip of him going, Trump will have a pandemic.
Yeah.
Him, when he defunded the pandemic team, they were probably like, okay, pandemic.
Yeah.
I mean, that's as simple as that.
Yeah, like just watching the, like hearing the news and shit like that and like the projection that they're putting on like Trump and shit, like saying, now this is his fault. He's not putting the numbers out right. It's like, dude, China literally just did this. What are we doing? You guys are literally faking numbers, giving everyone deaths. It's like, how is this Donald Trump's fault?
The frustrating thing that people, my frustration with the boomers is that they don't want to believe that the media is a wing of the CIA.
They literally, like, if you hit them with anything, it's like, why didn't CNN pick that? Or why didn't 60 Minutes pick that up? It's like, dude.
And what they don't want to realize is that the CIA controls the narrative, and they do it in a way to try to expose people that are dissidents.
Yes.
This has been going back since Vietnam.
Operation Mockingbird never stopped.
Well, yeah, and the Phoenix program that they did in Vietnam, this is how they took over South Vietnam. The goal of it was to create a war that never ended. Yeah. Like, Vietnam wasn't supposed to end. The protests and the soldiers coming home, Rambo, all that shit.
Was supposed to go on forever.
It's supposed to go on forever. Yeah. It's an endless way to do illegal drugs and arm deals and to keep funding for the military industrial complex.
Yeah.
This is the thing that Eisenhower warned everybody about. There's a lot of people that think that they know what the fuck's going on. They'll be like, oh yeah, I heard military industrial complex. It's like, I don't think you realize like Wall Street.
Yeah.
Like all of the inner cities.
Yeah.
Got fucking bodied by the drugs. All of this is the CIA.
Yes.
All of it. And then if you get mad and you call these Q people stupid for just hoping that there's a regime change in the intelligence, that's what that's about.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't know. It's just fucking, I get it, dude. It's military psyop, all that shit. But at the end of the day, what are we going to do? Live in another 100 years of the CIA bodying countries for resources? And then, meanwhile, just controlling the CIA infiltrated the media to the point where, like, people that write books are in the CIA.
Yes.
Like, they're CIA approved.
Yes.
The New York Times is CIA approved.
Yeah. I mean, like, if the war and stuff, like, having the CIA, like the wars for, like, all that shit is very costly and time-consuming. What they got going on right now seems like the Goldilocks zone of control. They can do whatever they want, push whatever they want. Everyone's like going the way they want to do it. And like this, it seems like it's like at a crossroad where if there is some sort of Q shit that's going on, if they can overthrow this, then shit'll be cool. But if this keeps up, we're fucked.
Yeah. If they keep doing the thing that they've been doing, like the Phoenix program type shit they've been doing, there's no end in sight to that. So good luck. That's every Western country's intelligence is just one intelligence.
Yeah.
And then there's mobs of drug dealers and arms dealers fighting for like the resources that whole big net brings in.
Yeah.
And meanwhile, there's dudes that are just like, oh, gotta get up and go to work today.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, dude, you gotta realize like we gotta get rid of this.
Yeah.
That's when people say like, oh, dude, like America's number one. Like, you're not psyched that America's number one. It's like, dude, America, I don't know if you want to call.
Too hot.
I don't know if you want to call that number one. Is that how you want to win?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, it is like, it's mind-numbing once you start trying to have even the conversation with someone. Like, if you talk to someone who's like way, like, coronavirus is real, they'll fucking like shit on you and be like, well, I believe in science. It's like, you obviously don't. You're obviously,
yeah,
you're pushed over this thing, because if you believe in science, you would listen to microbiologists talk about this and you wouldn't write
them off. They don't know that when they have a feeling when they were like, oh, but I think, like, they want to be on the side of the liberal elite. Mm-hmm. This is what Chris Hedges talks about this all the time, like how they get cucked.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, they want to be on the side of, like, the smart, the Atlantic,
yeah,
the New York Times, and all this shit, dude, like, all that Harper's, all these fucking magazines that, yeah, the elites read, they're all approved, like, thumbs up by intelligence. I mean, obviously, yeah, dude, like, they don't ask people that are going to have the wrong opinions to comment.
No.
You know?
And like, it is crazy that,
they,
like,
keep certain voices out for a reason.
You have to be insane to sit there and think that, like, the media isn't controlled, because if there's six people controlling the media, it's not that this magazine or this, like, website does really good reporting. It's they wanted them to get to the top.
I mean, that's America in a nutshell. It's a bunch of corporations that pay, that have Wall Street stocks.
Yeah.
That are funded by an illegal drug trade that's, yeah, over 100 years old. And, yeah, the media, that the world that you live in was created by MGM, 20th Century Fox.
Yeah. It's all fucking,
it's all Fugazis, dude. We didn't save everyone in World War II.
Yeah.
We there weren't all these heroes in the trenches of World War I.
It was a bunch of, dude,
it was a bunch of fucking kids that got murdered.
Yeah.
That's what it was, murder,
yeah,
by people that don't give a fuck about humanity.
Yeah.
They've done studies, dude. The more wealth and the more resources you have, the more you don't give a fuck about. Hey, man, you get rich, hate doesn't have a home there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They don't give a fuck. They'll throw you in a trench in no time.
Yeah, it is.
It's
crazy.
Fortunate son, dude.
Yeah.
The fucking shit is out there. Artists need to, like, that one chick that was on that thing, Matt Watch, that Brett Weinstein thing, you got to get that vibe out into the world that's beyond some intellectual.
Yeah.
Like, journal. You got to have it so that people can understand, like, wait, what?
Yeah.
And then they'll see right through this shit and go, holy shit, they're just drug dealers.
Yes. It is fucking insane. It's like all the, like, the high up elite people, like all their underling, like Renfield types, they will do anything to be a part of that conversation, to be at that dinner party and be able to say, well, I read this.
And you know why that thing is because they project.
Yes.
They don't. They're not up there on a psychological level.
If you got a bunch of psychopaths all together and they're all talking and all projecting on these fucking plebes that all walk around the streets, like.
Well, the personality types go hand in hand. So if there's a narcissist, they attract sycophants.
Yeah.
And then the sycophants.
It's all cult tap.
That the sycophants are like, oh man, that person okayed me, so I know them. They know, like,
yeah,
if you're known by the elites, you kind of get off on that.
Yeah.
And it's like, dude,
it's like the getting verified.
That's also a sickness.
Yeah.
You know, like, all of these things aren't going to get us where we got to go. Nah. These are all things to destroy us. And that's a level of control, man. If someone sees that you're acting like that, they're right on it, man.
Easily.
Someone sees that you can be manipulated, you're fucking,
especially if
fried.
They didn't grow up in a school, like going to school and doing that shit, and they had like an elite upbringing.
Oh,
where,
yeah,
it's,
man,
like, if someone's doing this, just do this. Like,
imagine what life's like for Chris Andrew right now, where he's just like, wait, what? I actually have to go talk to them.
Yeah.
I have to talk to the Americans.
Yeah.
Come on, guys. For real?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, he's sitting there, got confused.
Easily. I mean, imagine if instead of going to school to read about the fucking pilgrims and Indians and all that shit, you were like, third grade, this is how you control someone's, like, thoughts. This is how you, like win friends and shit like that. Like, these people aren't learning about the fucking pilgrims and Jonathan Smith and shit.
Yeah.
Like, these people going to these elite fucking schools and stuff like that, these boarding schools, they're not learning the shit you're learning.
No, I mean, what happens is when you get to a point, you get through the regular school,
yeah,
and then you go to get your master's and your PhD, and then you get to sit down, someone pays you a fellowship to sit down and research history.
Yeah.
And then you have these dudes, if you get paid, you read it from original sources, and you're like, wait, this is what happened?
Yeah.
And then there was a movement, like, not that long ago, at least maybe 20, in the last 20 years, of people like that Howard Zinn type shit, where they were like rewriting history, like revisionism.
Yeah.
Some people say it as a bad word, but it's like, you know, the whole 1619 Project type vibe. You know, they went through regular school, brainwashed until they were fucking 19 or 20.
Yeah.
If you're Prince Andrew, dude, you're chilling there and fucking the Queen's like, oh, come sit on my lap. I'll tell you how we took over South Africa.
Yeah.
Like, that's it, dude.
Yeah, that's why. Like, I knew a kid who was half DuPont and half Rockefeller, and he literally went to St. Andrews in Scotland for grade school.
Yeah.
You think we're learning the same shit?
No, man.
No.
Yeah.
These people are on a different level.
I mean, we didn't have
level.
Computers till I was fucking 13.
Yeah.
So...
It is insane, like, to sit there and, like, try to side with these people. Like, Bill Gates knows what's best for us. Fucking the Obama and all his, like, fucking people. Like, Hillary Clinton, they know what's best.
But you,
like,
can go back and watch clips of George H.W. Bush talk about how he wants stricter punishments for drug dealers.
Yeah.
Where, you know, he wants the guys that are destroying these communities to really have to pay for their crimes.
Yeah.
He was the one that was bringing in the drugs.
Yes.
Like, the guys that did Iran-Contra came and they bodied L.A. They bodied Miami. They bodied New York, Philadelphia, like, Detroit.
The worst part about all that is that is what happened. And it's like, oh, there's racist white cops. It's like, dude, you guys are missing the whole fucking point.
Well, that's because they're paying attention to the news.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
The news put that out there. The news also are the ones that cater the clips that you see, and the clips are meant to be divisive towards certain groups.
Yeah, I mean,
they're not gonna play some clips, man.
Yeah, the Aubrey Marcus thing, it's like, it's so split in half. Like, that guy was just jogging, this guy killed him. Like, they did that on purpose. They put that clip out on purpose. They only put a little bit of the story out on purpose so it would cause
division. Oh, you're talking about the shotgun guy?
Yeah, like, yeah. They didn't put out everything. They just put out that little clip.
Yeah, they'll do this all day long. And
it's insane. The Mike Brown shit, same shit. You put out a little bit of it, and then the country goes fucking insane.
They're funded by, like black suit drug dealers, like tuxedo drug dealers.
Yeah.
That, you know, it's all the intelligences of all of the fucking, the old British Empire.
And that's a fuck ton of money. Like, these people
bring all the money.
And then, like, you're going to sit there and say, oh, these are bad guys that are operating out of law. You go to the fucking wishy-washies, and they have all the police stickers on there. And the minute they stop paying, or there has to be a sacrificial lamb, someone gets arrested.
That's the way the world works.
Yeah, exactly.
They're the on a local level, cops are in on this. I mean, dude, how much grease do you know about, and you drive a trash truck?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I paint schools, and I see grease.
Yeah.
It's like, you know... What do you think? That gets worse, or does that get better as you go up, or does that get worse, man?
Exactly.
It's like, it goes to the top. The Obama thing against the, what is that called? Obamagate or whatever? Like, when they were trying to say, like...
Fast and Furious?
Oh, not Fast and... Well, Fast and Furious was cool, too, but Fast and Furious is a perfect example of what they do.
Yeah.
That's guns for money.
Yes.
That's like, the CIA does this all the fucking time, dude.
Yep.
Like,
and that's cash that funds their black operations that don't have to get approved.
And that cash is what keeps Wall Street liquid.
Yeah.
It's a tough pill to swallow for the hate has no home here people.
Yeah.
But their wealth,
yeah,
their lifestyle of like, well, look, let's see how the market's doing. All of that is based on... Have you ever seen the movie A Few Good Men? When Jack Nicholson's like... Yeah, I keep forgetting you don't watch movies. He's like, you can't handle the truth.
Yeah.
You ever see that clip?
Yeah.
That whole thing is like about this.
Oh,
like,
really?
You don't realize, like, we do this shit. Some Americans have to die to keep your fucking life going.
Yeah.
And Jack Nicholson's like, I don't want to hear it from a dude who sleeps under the blanket that I provide for him.
Yeah.
Because, you know, our world would be, they try to say that America would be way different if they didn't do this shit.
Okay, dude.
A certain section of America wouldn't be different.
Yeah.
The CIA definitely is racist.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like, but it's not a, there's no even playing field out there. Like, people are born into wealth. They want to hold on to it. That involves Wall Street.
And mental gymnastics. That's all it is.
They either are ignoring it or they just don't know. And, like, the royal elites,
I mean, if you know,
they don't give a fuck. Oh, yeah, for real.
Like, come on.
I don't know, man. You know, I've met a lot of real rich people that don't read books.
Yeah.
You know, they go to college and then that's it. They're like, oh, that's all I had to do. And that now I married this guy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, they just look, you know, a lot of them don't look into anything. And they have a comfortable life. And that's how they get psyoped into white privilege.
Yeah.
You know, like, they'll sit there and, like, be like, oh, that makes sense because I've had, like, such a chill life.
Yeah.
And it's like, that money you have in the bank account has some blood on it.
Most of it, yeah.
Yeah.
That is insane, dude. Yeah, that is tough to hear if someone is just, like, going about their day, like, completely normal, just doing good. It's like your whole existence is because drugs exist.
And human trafficking.
Like, the shit goes hand in hand.
Goes hand in hand. That's why I don't like it when people are like, oh, I'm going to invest in this and that. It's like, man, maybe you just get away from Wall Street and just start doing deals with people that you know.
Yeah.
It's weird, but they're like, oh, but that's how you secure a retirement. It's like, that's how we secure a retirement in this system.
Yes.
It's like, you want to be all these people that are like.
If you had a tight-knit community that all took care of each other, there would be no fucking.
This is what the Black Panthers were talking about. It's like, if you are sitting there and you're going to be like, Black Lives Matter, all that fucking bullshit, all these white kids that are fucking up Portland and all that.
Yeah.
I want to see bank statements.
Yes.
I want to sit there and go, would you give all that away right now?
Level the playing field.
Well, just if you're that passionate about it.
Yeah.
Like, I'll take anything I can get.
You're going to scream at my face when I'm at dinner.
I'll take anything I can get, and I'll fight for anything I have and that I try to get.
Yeah.
Like, I'll fight to keep it.
Yeah.
But, like, once I get money, do I have to sit there and I have to stare at the stock market one day and be like, well, I got to fucking contribute to this now.
No.
You know what I mean? Insane. I'm going to have to dump back into
Hopefully
this fucking blood money.
Stays stable.
For real, dude. I don't understand how it all works. I mean, I'm not an econ. I just love how, like,
sorcery,
economists are like, well, we're in this fiat currency and we're going to do this and that. And it's like all that, like what you're saying, mental gymnastics. It's like you got to do all this shit to make this make sense.
It's like Larry Nassar trying to explain, like, how. Why do you have to finger little girls? And it's like, well, if you look at the NASDAQ and where the oil prices are actually on the northeast side of the southwest border, and you know, I mean, you won't get it, but you know,
we've been doing covert ops. What they're doing, they're ushering out things in Africa right now. I mean, supposedly the Trump administration has been doing covert ops this whole time.
Really?
God knows what the fuck they're doing, but they're keeping. This is what I'm saying. All this shit's going on, and the stock market's going up. You got to sit there and go, well, what the fuck? And billionaires just made like 500 and something billion. Like,
yeah, it's insane.
So you're sitting there just going like, well, what's going on, man?
That's like we talk about all the time. Like, none of this makes sense. Because if there was some like depression, crazy thing on the horizon, shit would be stopping.
It would make sense if you like took over like, you know, countries that can make opium.
Yeah.
And then create an opioid epidemic through big pharma and then cut the supply off and then release the heroin and then take the heroin, release the Pfizer.
Yeah.
And then that game's not going to stop. That's a whole market. That's a whole stock market right there.
Yeah.
I mean, talk to a drug dealer. They'll know exactly how much stuff costs.
Yeah.
And it fluctuates.
Same with scrap.
It's same exact shit. Fucking shit, dude.
We'll stop there. Go to the Patreon.
Oh, okay. Yeah.